So welcome everybody. Welcome to Hat Song Podcast. Today is September the 26th, 2024, and the topic for this episode is called In This Moment. Why in this moment? Somebody already asked me why in this moment, because that's what we are all called to do. I remember a little while ago, I already shared with you that my guides told me, my guides asked me to embody cosmic love. And they told me that, and I was like, huh? What is cosmic love? What is embodiment? More explanation, please. So I was not too sure. And then, of course, I was not sure. My personality was not sure, but my soul knew what to do. So I was guided to take the steps, and gradually I really got to a lot of different, I would say, realizations that, and then one after another after another. And then my guides told me that, oh yep, yes, you did it. And I was like, I did what? What did I do? Because I didn't really do anything, not according to my mind, not according to my to Winnie, not according to my personality. And then I realized that, yep, my soul actually has made the journey already. It's made the choices, made the decision. And what I am experiencing now is really the unfolding of that. So the choice was made, and I made that choice. But now I'm witnessing the unfolding, and it's like every day something new come about, and I am just witnessing everything. And one of the things I really wanted to share before I get back to the moment thing was oh, okay, long time ago. How many years ago? I don't know, at least about 20 something years ago. Oh, actually way longer than that. Maybe 30, 40 years ago. I lost somebody that I really love. Really thought I loved that person, and I lost for whatever reason, which is no longer important anymore. And I remember, in my ignorance at the time, I was just mourning the loss of that relationship. And I think I was depressed for the longest time. I don't know, long time, maybe years, a few years, let's say. And I finally, dig myself out of that. And that, I think that created a depression that created a resistance to loss in my heart. And so after all these years, this is one of those things that I needed to let go of in order to embrace cosmic love, because this is like my job is to embody cosmic love. So all these, I would say, what's the word for it? Misunderstanding. Yes, misunderstanding about love, I have to revisit. And one of them was that relationship. So I have to revisit that. And after, I would say after a while, like I was revisiting and really feeling it. And I was like, oh, this love, I wanted something like this again. And then after a while, it finally hit me that that's not love. That's absolutely not love at all. What I was hanging on to was actually the loss. I was actually hanging on to the feeling of, or the resistance to the loss of this love. And that's actually what I was feeling. And once I got that, it was like, whoa, It totally flipped me around that, what I thought is love is actually nothing at all. It's not love that I have experienced or wanted to experience. Actually, it was loss. So, and I was addicted to this loss, this resistance to love, for the longest time. And so now I can finally let that go. And this just maybe happened this week. Within this week, I had that realization, and it was like something that I've been hanging on to for, I don't know, 40, 50 years. Well, maybe not 50 years, but at least 40 something years. So that's, and I really feel the now I can actually grasp it a lot better. And so it actually made me look at life, all of life. And I really realized that life, actually, everything is perfect. Everything is perfect. Absolutely everything is perfect. And we don't think that it is perfect because we actually hanging on to the resistance. We're hanging on to that feeling of resistance. It's not, we're not actually hanging on to the thing that we want. We're actually hanging on to the resistance. And that's why we suffer. And that's why we think that it is wrong. But it's, nothing is wrong. The world is the way it is. It's perfect. Absolutely is perfect. And I absolutely know that, yes, it took me 40 somewhat years to realize it, but it's not too early, it's not too late. I knew the reason why I was hanging on to that, but I couldn't resolve it at the time because I was not mature enough to resolve it. Not that I'm not emotionally mature, but I was actually not spiritually mature enough to resolve it, because what I felt as at the human level was actually there was a reason behind it. There was a spiritual reason. When I become, I would say, mature enough to handle the spiritual reasons and to let go of the spiritual reasons, then the human reasons is easy to resolve. I would say it's relatively easy to resolve. So this moment in life, we think we live in this dimension, but actually we live in all dimensions, all at the same time. We're influenced by different dimensions. It's just that we're not consciously aware of the input from all the different dimensions. And when we encounter someone that really breaks our heart or do things to, stab us at the back or betray us or do anything bad to us, the reason, yes, there is a human reason, but there are also reasons from a different dimension. And the reasons from the different dimensions actually filter down to the human dimension and created a story. So at the human dimension, we work with the pattern. And the way it works is that if it's something, let's say, for example, if it is a unresolved romantic relationship, for example, if it's that, then that unresolved issue would, like, you would repeat that over and over and over again same lifetime or even different lifetimes. You would repeat that over and over again until you actually understand what's really behind it. When you understand what's really behind it, then you can shift it. It's actually, you don't even have to do much. It will shift. And that's how it is. That's how energy works, is when we create something that we don't want, that we're resisting, then we actually, the resistance actually keep us in that loop over and over and over again until we get to the part where at a soul level we say, okay, enough is enough. What is it here that I needed to get? And when the soul gets it, then the human level does not have to repeat that pattern anymore. And then when it gets to that, it's actually very easy to shift. So each moment is absolutely perfect. And why do I want to say that? I mean, you look at the world now and you think that it's crazy. And yes, I know it looks crazy outside. But the world is actually a reflection of what's inside. And if you think that there's no way the world is a reflection of what's inside me because I don't have these things inside me. Well, we do. It's just that you are not consciously aware of it. Because if you look at, if you really look at from the point of view of oneness, it's everything that happens to anyone else, it's actually happening to all of us, to everyone. So it is within us. And what we are seeing is simply a reflection of that. So don't get upset because, as I mentioned, it's perfect. So do what it is that is in front of you in this moment to deal with. If in this moment to, in front of you to deal with is simply to have a sip of water, then that's all you need to do. And then the next moment, the next thing would show up. And just moment by moment, whatever it is that you needed to know, you needed to do will come to you. And it's the system is made in the way that it is infinite, infinite, beyond infinite time and space, is actually beyond time and space. Within time and space is where we witness how it's being resolved. Beyond time and space is already resolved. Every story is already resolved. So within time and space, what we are doing now is we actually witnessing each one of us doing our part, living each day, making the choices. And we do make different choices. We may not make a different choice or the right choice or the choice that's going to break the pattern that keeps us looped in an undesirable situation. However, we break the pattern just by observing it and just by making a slightly different choice each moment. And the slightly different choice may not be something that we do. It could be something that we focus on or don't focus on. So something as simple as that, just something that happens within a split second can make a big difference. So that's what I want to share, what I want to talk about. So, comments, questions.
many questions, but I'll just stick with this one for now. How does it relate to matrix?
Can you expand on what you mean by matrix?
I'm sorry?
Can you expand on what do you mean by matrix?
I mean, we've been talking about it, how matrix is, you know, it's not real, it's creating issues, blah, blah, blah.
Okay. The matrix is, for example, is the matrix is simply a box. Or, okay, let's say your house. So the matrix is, you can think of matrix as your house. Within the house, there are certain things that you can do and certain things that you can't do. So because of that structure of the house limits you to what it is that you can or cannot do within it. So that's all it is. It's just a box.
Okay,
Let me expand on it. Okay. When you say matrix, there's not just one matrix. There are matrices of matrix. So there are so many boxes.
Mm-hmm.
So even if you manage to break out of this matrix, there is still another matrix beyond. So you're never out of matrix. So if somebody ever told you that the matrix is bad, well, maybe the matrix that you are living in can be construed as being bad, but it is not. It is just a sandbox for you to play in.
Okay.
And when the time comes, you will go out of it and you will walk out of it and you will go to the next sandbox.
Next level. Okay.
The next level. Yes. If you think that it is bad, no, it is not bad. It is not good. It is not bad. It is just a playground. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, so even the spiritual world is a matrix. So that's what you're saying. Everything is like a matrix.
Yep.
Okay.
It is just a bigger box, but it is still a box. And they're still beyond the spiritual.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
I have a question, Winnie.
Sure. Yep.
When you say that everything is good as it is, I agree with that. But then, why do we say not mine activate? Why do we have to clean ourselves by saying that? Because, yeah, so that's my question.
Okay. Good question. Because we've been taught that we need to fit in. We've been taught that we need to do what others are doing so that we can survive. So that is the program, that is the belief. However, that's actually not correct. That's just what we are supposed to be actually is that we need to be with us, be ourselves, no matter what. It's just that not everyone can be so brave, because to be ourselves, absolutely 100% be ourselves, say what we want to say, do what we want to do all the time in every moment, it takes a lot of courage. It's just like when everybody have a mask on, you don't wear a mask because you don't believe in it. It takes courage. When everybody does something, when everybody, let's say, eats celery, and you decided that, no, I want beets instead, and you go and, you know, grow beets instead of celery, it takes courage, it takes guts. So in order to fit in order to not get attacked, because when you're different, you get attacked.
Yeah.
And in order to be safe, we do what other people do. We take on other people's beliefs, we take on other people's behavior, yeah, all that. So that is okay up to a certain extent. That is okay for, it's like we need training wheels. So however, at some point in life, when you actually get spiritually mature enough, then you can start to stand up. You can start to see what it is that no longer, that I shouldn't say no longer, actually has never been yours. You just took it on because you thought it was the thing to do at the time, but actually it never was. You're just doing it because you weren't mature enough to handle it. So now you can just say, not mind release, activate, should you choose to.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm
so
not saying
in
it is right or, I'm not saying it is right or wrong. It's, I'm just saying that when you want to grow up, then the only way to do is you don't look outside. You look within and you be who you are, you stand up, you do it every moment, and you do it long enough and consistent enough, then you will start to, like, another part of you will start to come up. And no one else can tell you that you're wrong. Because one can.
Yeah. Makes sense. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Any other comments, suggestion?
Yeah, Winnie, I was just, you know, when you saying about the boxes, you know, if I could imagine there's a heap of boxes and I've chosen or I'm in one of these boxes, and it could be right now, you know, in America, I suppose, is they're in the political box, you know, and you're totally consumed by the this crap that's going on out there. Now, in what you're saying now, there comes a time when you say, well, I'm done with this. I think, you know, this is what you're saying. You know, I've been through this. I know what's going to happen. I know how it's going to play out. I don't want to experience. I've already, you know, I can see it, sort of thing. So I want to jump into another box. Now, I think that is that right? And therefore, in going to another set of experiences, you know, I don't know, you, like you said, in the growing or the spiritual side, I want to go into, you know, and after a while you might say, I've got as much as I can out of that. So is it a process of growing, I suppose you could say, but jumping from one box to another box, and, you know, or what is it? You know, I just a bit confused on that. That's all. I can get the bit about, I think that's what you were saying. It's, you know, you're there and you say the political thing. I don't want to be there, or the freedom stuff or the vaccine stuff, or, you know, you can go jump and be totally engrossed in each one of them. Not, actually, you can see people like that, you know, that's all. They're totally consumed. They are in this box, but it and that's not judgmental. It's perfect for them, I'd say. But you get to a stage where you want to move. I don't know, am I correct in saying that, Winnie, or what am I getting all it all wrong? Back to you.
Yeah, at some point you. So we've been also trained that authority is outside. So that's why political system is to do with authority. So authority is outside. So that's why we try to find the correct, quote unquote, correct authority, the correct government, the right people to be in government so that, you know, we can live well. So all that. But that's just outside. That we still, no matter how good a system is, it's still outside. The authority is still outside. And that's the box that we're playing with, is who has the authority. So now we are all, we've all been trained to give our authority to the government, to teachers, to doctors, to scientists, you know, all those things. Everybody that's besides us is have all the authority. And then that's the box we're playing in. And a different box is you don't give authority to anyone else. You start to cultivate your own authority. You know that, yes, the government can dictate things that you can or cannot do, but things that you really feel within your own being that you want to do, and you give yourself that authority, then you will find a way to create that situation for yourself. So it's about taking back authority. So when you take back authority, there are so many levels of taking back authority. At the human level, it's like, yeah, if you want to take back authority, then there are certain things that you can do. At the spiritual level, is really to understand that, in fact, there is nothing that you cannot do. Absolutely nothing that you cannot do. You can create anything. You have that authority to do. You have the ability to do. There are always consequences. And when you know why you do something, when it's the consequences depends on why you do things. So depending on, are you creating something out of fear, or are you creating something out of unity, out of oneness? So that's what I mean by why, the why. Why do you do something? Because the why actually is part of the creation. Something that you may create and you make a choice this moment, and it will play out, and it depends on all the energy or the thought patterns that goes into creation. And then in time, you would see how those choices play out. So and what I'm trying to say is, yes, there are boxes. And for I would say pretty much it's going to take a lot more increase of consciousness to get to the point where at some point there will be no boss. It's just that now we're still not mature enough to take off all the training wheels. At some point, there will be nothing. And there will be no limit. We're not anywhere near that yet. So boxes, yes. And you can choose to play in any box with consciousness. Did I answer your question?
Yeah, very, very good. Yeah, I see that, you know, authority out there, and it's losing authority and coming into sovereign, in being sovereign and being allowing you to, you know, to be there. I think this was saying, and I see that, you know, like when you just said that we break through all that, and you still, it's all, it's not that. It's like we're going through it all, but we've got to go through all these boxes, sort of thing, and that's only, and we, it's only because we think that, you know, we are thinking that we've got to do this and we've got to do that, you know, and it's most probably another form of authority, but you're not going to the heart of the matter is the oneness, you know, and be sovereign and allow that to come through. I think I don't. Yeah. Over and out.
Okay, thank you. Any other comments, questions?
Look, a couple of things came up for me. Maturity. If you have to have certain maturity to even, I guess, think about these things or know about these things. And the other one was neutral. Can you be neutral or decide you're not going to participate, let's say, in that box we were talking about?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yes, maturity comes from making mistakes. Uh-huh. When you make enough mistakes, you will mature. So go ahead and make mistakes.
Right. Yep.
Yep. Don't try to be correct. Just be you. When you be you, you make the mistakes that you're supposed to make, and you learn the things that you're supposed to learn. So.
Right. Yep. Thank you.
Thank you. No, that's it. No more. Okay. Let me see if I missed anything. Okay. Perfect. Everything is perfect. Yep. Got that. Okay. 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 Let me just one. I just want to repeat two things. Just want to repeat two things that we don't really experience love. We actually experience the fear of loss, and we experience our own resistance to loss, and you would know that it is true cosmic love when it is holistic. It never leaves, it never comes, because it's already here. It does not have to come. It's already here. It's already the fabric of all things, of all creations, of everything that you can ever experience, see, hear, smell, taste. It's the fabric of all. That's cosmic love. So it love, that kind of love does not come, it does not leave. It always is and always will be. And will we ever experience that? I sure hope so. I definitely hope so. I hope I'm there to witness it. Not there yet, but I definitely intend to stay long enough to witness that. Okay, that's about all I want to talk about tonight. So if no more questions.
I'm getting really confused. So sure. There is cosmic love, it always is, right? It doesn't come, it doesn't go. But that's not the same as what's happening in this moment.
This moment is the same as well. It never comes.
It's the same?
It never goes. It never comes. It never goes. It's always there. You're always in the moment.
But it changes.
It changes because you're looking at it at the point of view of the past or the future. When you're in the moment, you're always looking at the same thing. It does not move. It does not change.
Wow. Okay, got it.
Got it? Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
No more? Okay, great. Thanks. Well,